Hell, I never have. March into a country club.
Shit, McGuire, who has?
Frank, I only have an hour. I have to be in Fort Lauderdale at 5 o'clock.
Watch you like this all day long.
Caddyshack around the back.
In.
Get here.
Now, I bet you're all wondering, is this a hold up? Is this a goddamn revolution?
This is a hold up.
Move! Get up! Move! 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 Get up!
Right, motherfucker! You would die in that chair! Move! Get up! Move!
Step out. Line up.
Morning, gentlemen. I'm a new attorney.
I didn't know we had one.
Well, you do now. My name is Marshall Fine.
Is that fine or fine and dandy?
I'll be fine when we get out of here.
Tell me, Mr. McGuire, what was your photo doing under the backseat of Mr. Patterson's car?
I borrowed Andre's car to get my picture taken with my passport. What's going on?
Excuse me, your passport?
Yeah, I was on my way to France. Sort of a dream I had.
Well, Mr. McGuire, I think seriously about postponing your travel plans.
Any questions?
All rise. 36th District Court for the State of Michigan, City of Detroit is now in session.
What do you mean free? Like free to go? Just like that?
The witness from the country club, little guy, he saw your picture before he came down to look at the lineup. He picked you out clean.
I don't get it.
What it amounts to is the cops screwed up. See, they can't show your picture to anybody unless your lawyer is in the room. That's me, and I wasn't. Tainted justice, my friend. Good luck. Now get your ass out of here. Oh.
I forgot. You need a job? What are you going to do now?
What about the money?
No charge.
No, what I mean is, I got money coming to me.
Well, you must have made some kind of arrangement.
See, the problem is, we got picked up before we got paid.
Oh, well, that'll be your tough luck.
Somebody owes me.
Somebody lives in Florida. That's a long way from here.
But maybe we can help you.
Were you working? I was a bartender, but I quit.
Yeah, I could get you something like that, tending bar.
How about Miami Beach? I was down there about 10 years ago. That sounds like a good idea.
I could get you into one of the hotels.
No, possibly. No, I work with dolphins.
Excuse me?
Porpoise. You know, people call them porpoise, but they're really dolphin.
You mean like a SeaWorld, the guy who has a killer whale?
Yeah, but the place I worked at was more like a training school.
You say porpoise or porpoises?
Either way.
Nice, clean animals.
Yeah, they are.
Okay, give me a call in a couple days. I'll see what I can do.
Andre and Grover.
Well, too bad they didn't leave any pictures. They'll do some time.
Sorry about your tie.
Hey, I got a closet full of them.
Will is pretty simple.
Ask me anything. What do you want to know?
What am I worth?
Approximately $15 million.
And do I get that in a lump sum?
According to the way Frank set it up, the money's held in trust.
Oh.
Miami General Revenue Bonds. That's $15 million at 6%. That's $900,000 a year. How's that sound?
Do I pay tax on it?
No, they're municipal bonds. Their earnings are not taxable. That's $900,000 a year. Or the way it's set up, $75,000 a month for as long as you live.
Well, what if I want to take the entire $900,000 all at once?
And do what?
I don't know. I'm just saying, what if? Are the bonds in my name?
No. Frank appointed Dorado Management administrator of his estate. Now, to answer your question, yes, you can take the $900,000 for a given year in one payment. But for your protection, it would have to be approved by Dorado Management.
By you?
Karen, I could cross Flagler Avenue and get hit by a bus. The corporation is still the administrator of Frank's estate. Follow me? It's like a service to you.
So I can't just cash in the bonds if I want to take the $15
million? Well, why would you want to?
What if I marry again?
Oh, I think it stops.
It stops?
Well, let me see. I don't recall. Maybe Dorado Management has to approve. You interested in somebody?
Not at the moment. I barely see anyone. I just want to know what my rights are, what I'm allowed to do and what I'm not.
It's Frank's money, Karen.
And I earned a share. Wife, subject to the husband, faithfully living up to my end. If you want to make this sound like a legal contract, Ed...
Look, Karen, Frank's dead. What do you want him to do? Come back and apologize? The man left you a house, a couple of other places, $1 million a year, tax-free. What do you want?
I don't know. I just feel trapped. Maybe I just need to get away for a few months.
Well, you don't have to run off, do you? I mean, get involved in something here, some kind of club activity.
You sound like Frank.
Well, that's very possible. Frank and I were together a long time. I mean, he says something, this is his wish, then it's going to be my wish, too. I mean, I don't have to agree with Frank entirely, but he let me know that this is the way he wants it. Okay, that's the way it's going to be. What else can I do for you? You want some coffee? I got mints.
Why don't you want me to go away?
Do I have to have permission?
Of course not. I didn't mean it like that. I'm suggesting that you take it easy. Stay here. Let me know what you're doing and if I can help you in it.
I'll tell you right now what I'm doing. Nothing. I see someone 2-3 times, just dates. I'm not looking to jump into bed with anybody. We have some laughs. We get along. And then they say they're going to call me tomorrow or in a couple of days. And then nothing. No explanation. Not a word.
Karen, you've only been a widow, what? I mean, 6 months? I mean, what's your rush?
Ed, what's going on?
What do you mean, what's going on? They're businessmen. Maybe they're busy. Maybe they're out of town.
No, they're not out of town. I've seen them.
Maybe their wives found them.
I'm not married. Is this because I was married to Frank DeCilia?
Well, you never know. I mean, the guy's a lightweight. Sooner or later, it shows. I mean, he starts to get nervous. He looks around. He thinks, Jesus Christ. Maybe I'm over my head. I wouldn't worry about it if I were you.
Well, you're not me, Ed. You have no idea what I worry about. Thank you.
Don't mention it.
Wasn't that Frank's woman just left?
Her name is Mrs. DeCilia.
Arnold Rapp? What kind of name is that? This dink know what he's doing, or is he one of them college boys?
Arnold tells us the Coast Guard impounded his boat. Turned 9 tons of grass over to customs. We see in the paper, yes, there is a boat. Cuban crew pulled into Boca Chica 2 days ago.
But was it Arnold's boat? What'd you bank him for?
540 grand, 2.5 to 1.
Well, if he's telling the story, he must have smoked a ton of it to get the nerve, huh?
Well, ask him. The other madam, Mrs. DeCilia, Vivian, will tell you. Vivian?
Yes, Mr. Grossi.
Roland's coming out.
Oh, how'd I make it up with Butler? Well, just fine, Ed. I kept my hands on my private parts, and I broke a boy's arm, tried to cop my joint, and I came out a 205-pound virgin.
Vivian's waiting.
He's going to take so much and then fire you. You know it.
I could use a thank you for keeping my mouth shut, standing up to that asshole judge. You know what I kept dreaming about all the time I was there? Cuban pussy. Man, all that black hair.
Well, I know one Cuban cochay you're never going to see. Roland, get your butt off my desk. Act nice.
All righty. Just the facts, ma'am.
Mrs. Frank DeCilia, 1 East La Bahia, out on the Intercoastal, out in Lauderdale. There's a tap on the phone line that goes into Marta's room from the outside.
Who's Marta?
Marta Diaz, her maid. Sister of Jesus.
Well, sweet Jesus working on this? Never knew he had a sister.
The recorder's in Marta's room. Every night she takes out the cassette and gives it to Jesus.
Then what?
Then he was bringing it here. Now, we give it to you. You listen to it. You write down the names of the men she talks to. She looks like she's got something going on with one of them. You find out about him. You go and see him. And tell him that Mrs. DeCilia would like to be left alone. Yeah, you understand. And you don't hit anybody unless you ask us first.
What, does Ed want her for himself?
It's not his idea, it's the husband's.
Frank's dead.
Is that right? But people still do what Frank wants. He wants his wife to remain faithful to him even after his death. And we see to it.
Who knows about the setup?
The three of us. But Mr. Grossi doesn't want to be involved. The woman's also a friend. Doesn't even want to hear himself tell you about it. That's why I'm telling you.
Well, what about Jesus? He knows.
Jesus believes that woman is being protected.
Protected? Well, I guess I can do that. Keep all the dinks away from her silk panties.
Roland, while you're protecting her silk panties, just make sure you're not trying to get in them yourself. I told you, she's a very good friend of Ed's.
Well, we're all friends here, darling. That's why we get along so good. I don't get any extra. I just did 6 months of butler hard time, lady, and I pick up my paycheck as usual, huh?
Join a union.
Here's Brad.
And now
here's Brad.
How many times, McGuire? How many times do I have to tell you? You don't just say, and now here's Brad. You know, it's Johnny Carson. Remember how they did it? Remember that? And now, here's Johnny. See, that's what I want. And now, here's Brad.
Okay, sorry. I'm having a little trouble with that. I'm sorry.
Are you learning impaired? See, I don't think you are, and I don't think this is that difficult, okay?
Okay, it's just a down a marathon. We had a show, and it wasn't quite like this show.
Look, tell me something. Down there, could you name all the dolphins? I mean, could you identify each and every dolphin by name?
Yeah, I could.
How come you can't do it here?
I can. Yeah, there's Penny, Dixie, Bonsai, Pepper.
You know, McGuire, yesterday, Robin tells me that you tried to get Penny to do the tail walk. Is that right?
Thanks a lot, Robin.
See, Penny doesn't do the tail walk, McGuire. Pebbles does the tail walk.
I get those two mixed up.
Well, work on it. Just work on it, okay? Take Robin over to the tank with you and see if you can name all the dolphins for her. And then when you're done there, come on back to the show pool and see if you can do it for me, okay? Simple. And now, here's Brad.
I bet you a bowl of black beans this little punk Arnold Rapp is the kind of boy been to about 5 colleges, traveled all over, got busted a couple times, has his rich folks bail him out, and he thinks he's a fucking outlaw. You think I'm wrong?
No, you're right, man.
See, they get together, these snotty boys like Arnold, they think shit. They've been to college, dumb guineas financing the deal, don't know nothing. Tell them the load went down the toilet and keep your money.
Maybe.
No maybe. These little shitheads are pulling something. You don't believe it?
I believe it if you want me to. Why are they in business then?
They make more selling it, don't they?
They do sell it, you dink, but they told Grossi they lost it and he's out his dough.
They believe they can get away with that.
That's why we're here, Jesus. That's why we're here.
When I was a boy,
hey,
I thought
your mommy home?
No, no mommy, just us kids.
Well, now who are you little friends, Arnie?
Well, now this here's Barry, and that there's Kenny.
And who be you be?
Hey, man, that's final. What are you doing?
Getting your attention.
Yo, who be you be, man?
He's the who be you be, man. Comes in, who be you be's your fucking records all up.
No, I'm the man's man. Sent me to ask you what happened to his $540,000.
It's in the municipal incinerator.
Yeah, we already told the man. Ask him. Cowboy piece of shit.
Let's go cow tipping.
Fucking bronco, bronco.
Now why don't you tell me what you told the man?
Coast Guard picked up the boat in international waters and brought it into Boca Chica. He knows all that. The pot went to customs and they burned it.
Pot went to pot?
The crew, the three guys, were turned over to the DEA. Your man is out the 540 grand and there's nothing I can do about it.
It's a high fucking risk business, man. Anytime you get 200.5% on your investment, you know it's high risk going in. If you're not stupid.
Is that right, little fella? You know all about high risk, do you?
Stand up here. Let me have a look at you.
Jesus Christ, why don't you take a fucking walk?
Whoa, whoa, whoa!
See that? Now tell me about high risk.
You want me to tell you, huh? In fact, I'm gonna show you, boy, highest risk you ever saw.
Hey, 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 take it slow, buddy.
No! Please, no!
Boy's lucky, you know what? He hit in the swimming pool. He's moving slow, but he's moving. People are gonna say, what do those boys do up there? Must get all liquored up, huh? Now, who be you be? Whoobies gonna answer my question without getting all smart ass and giggling like little kids. Careful. Next one might hit the cement.
The name of the boat in the paper was Salsa. Same one I hired. I know, because I saw it in Key West 2 weeks ago.
And the name of the Coast Guard cutter hauled it in was a Diligence. Same thing I'm going to use till you pay us back the $540,000. Now, you can take your time, Arnie. We're reasonable folks. As long as you understand, the VIG is 54 grand a week. It's just standard 10% interest.
We'll pay you. Don't worry.
Do I look worried? You owe me that bowl of black beans.
Whatever.
I told you, didn't I? Them dinks would pull something.
They weren't lying to you. It was the same boat that was picked up.
You don't know shit, do you, Jesus?
I heard what I heard.
You understand when you work for me, there's only room for one of us thinking.
I didn't understand that, no.
Think about it when you're walking home.
What do you mean walk?
I got business up in Lauderdale.
Someone here to see you, miss.
Who?
He says he's a friend of Mr. Grossi. Mr. Crow? You're supposed to have met him one time before.
Did I?
I never see him.
Ask him to come out.
Good girl, what are you doing, huh? Oh, little baby. How are you, doggy? You cute little doggy. What's her name?
Gretchen.
Well, I thought there was some of you out there, but this one sure beats it.
What's funny?
Oh, nothing. I was just thinking. See, the problem, this place is pretty exposed out on a point. It'd be easy for somebody to get in here, maybe clean out the jewel box.
We have a security service. It's around here all night.
Yeah, well, those rent-a cops ain't worth it. They're mostly older, retired fellas. I was down there looking to see if there's any evidence of somebody trying to set the place up. See, I was originally from over in the Everglades. Used to track and hunt, so I got a fairly keen eye for reading signs.
Would you like something cold, Mr. Crow?
Sure, that'd be fine.
Marta, a couple of vodka and tonic, okay?
Vodka's good. Next time, beer.
Is this your idea, or did someone send you?
Well, coming here was my idea, but I wouldn't be here, would I, if it wasn't for the situation?
What situation exactly are we talking about?
I'm not allowed to tell.
But you're going to, aren't you, or you wouldn't be here?
Figure that out, huh? Let's just say I don't think it's fair you living like this and not knowing.
Isn't that right, Gretchen?
Yeah, good girl. Yeah, you're a good girl.
Thank you, Marta. What is it that you're going to tell me, Mr. Crow?
What it is, you're not supposed to see anybody. I mean, any man who might have serious or sexual intentions.
I beg your pardon?
And I'm supposed to keep him away from you.
Protecting the widow, huh? I guess I'll have to have a talk with Mr. Grossi.
Well, there's a little more to it.
This is Ed's idea, isn't it?
No, it's your husband's.
My husband?
He left word, no man gets near you. Serious, fooling around, one-nighter, or anything like it, as long as you live. In other words, your husband cut off your action.
You're not kidding, are you?
It's what they tell me.
I'll have a talk with Ed tomorrow.
You sure you want to do that?
We're gonna quit playing games. I'm sure of that.
The way I see it, one you'd have to talk to is Frank. He's the only one who can call it off. Ed, he's respecting the wish of his dead buddy. You know how them people are. He can't change nothing. It's a code or some bullshit like that. But you go see Ed, tell what you know. He's liable to take me off the job and put on somebody else ain't as sympathetic.
Why are you sympathetic?
Because I ain't one of them. I didn't take no oaths or shit, so I can sympathize and maybe help you.
I'm not sure I follow you.
You're a beautiful woman. You're not young, but you're beautiful. And here you are, stuck here, starting to dry up. And here I am, just filled with notions, going to waste working for them guineas. It's like...
I won't tell if you won't. You scratch mine, I'll scratch yours, and we'll get something cooking here. I'm giving you your big chance, Sugar. It's the only chance you got.
My big chance.
That's right. Me.
She just stood there staring out at the water. She was very upset.
What did you do?
I said to her, are you all right? She didn't answer. Then she went to the phone and called Mr. Grossi.
Lo escuchaste? You could hear it?
She was making her words very clear, saying, I never want to see that animal again, understand? Then saying, keep him away from here.
All that with Mr. Grossi is on this tape?
Yes, of course, every vocal today.
If I give it to Roland, he'll hear it. He'll know she called Mr. Grossi.
Then don't give it to him.
Está loca. Roland ain't nothing but a bad taste.
A wife is faithful to her husband. She is subject to him. That's in the Bible.
If I don't tell you what I'm doing, I'm being unfaithful.
What is it you want to do?
Maybe I'll just do it and I'll tell you.
What?
Not tell you where I go or who I see. Tell you that I'm going to play tennis and maybe I do something else.
You know, a man comes to me and gives me some shit out of the side of his mouth. I tell him, that's it, pal. Get the hell out or talk straight. I'm a lot more patient with you, Karen, because you're my wife. Don't ever threaten me like you're going to pay me back for something. I know all about paying back, Karen. I could write a book on paying back. Then take a look at it and realize I left a few things out. You understand?
My mother was right. You can do whatever you want, and I can.
What the hell is the matter with you? What is it?
No more double standard. If it's all right for you to fool around, it's all right for me to fool around.
It isn't all right. The Bible says it isn't, and I say it isn't.
I may not even want to, but I'll do it as a matter of principle, and you can see how you like it.
Like plates, Mr. McGuire?
I know a little. You got some nice things in here. The Bergère, is that authentic, Louis says?
The what?
The chair. If it's real, it belongs in a museum.
It is in a museum.
I was hoping I could speak to your husband, Mrs. DeCilia. Is he home?
Mr. DeCilia is dead, but... You already knew that, didn't you?
No, I didn't. Sorry.
Were you a good friend of Frank's?
Actually, I worked for him once.
Oh, and you want to know if I'm all right, is that it? Well, how do I look to you, Mr. McGuire? Do I look all right to you?
I had an arrangement with your husband, Mrs. DeCilia.
Oh, I know all about the guy!
You do.
Are you with Roland or are you on your own?
I don't know anyone named Roland.
Ah, you're an independent. All right, well, let's go on out to the patio. That's where we hold the squeeze sessions. Come on, I'm anxious to hear your pitch.
Would you like something to drink, Mr. McGuire? Vodka?
Vodka'd be fine.
Two vodka tonic.
So besides all this, what's it like to be rich? Never mind.
If you really want to know, it's boring. Let's just get to the point, okay?
Okay, let's do that.
What's that?
Myself and two associates. We're offered $5,000 apiece by your husband to rob this place. We did the job. We never got paid.
Deep Run Country Club, Detroit.
That's the one.
Yeah, Frank played golf there a couple of times as a guest. He liked the club, so he applied for a membership.
I bet you they turned him down.
Well, what is it you want? $5,000?
Each, for the three of us. My two associates were convicted, but I'll make sure they get taken care of.
You got off?
Yeah, it's a long story, and if you're already bored.
That's all you want?
That's all I got coming to me.
You could have said 50,000.
And you could have known about the arrangement. It's a straight five apiece. No sick pay, no retirement benefits.
Mr. McGuire.
Thank you.
You live here in Florida? Just visiting.
Actually, I work over here at Seascape. The porpoise show.
Yeah, past it. You really work there? I mean, you get the porpoises to jump through hoops, that kind of thing?
Yeah, everything but mate in midair.
They won't do that for you?
I think they go to a hotel for that.
Amazing.
Well, not really. I mean, I don't blame them. I wouldn't want people watching me.
No, I mean that you work there. And you seem to know antiques. What else do you do?
You mean like rob country clubs and not get paid for them? You gonna honor your husband's obligation, Mrs. DeSilia?
Do that sort of thing often?
What sort of thing?
Rob country clubs.
It's my first time.
But you've robbed other places. You care a gun?
You fuck around?
What?
You just pick up young guys or you ask a lot of personal questions?
I don't believe you came to me. And I haven't asked you a personal question yet.
Wait here.
Remember what you said about Rich being boring? I don't believe you.
$15,000.
Thank you. I'm gonna take off.
Can I ask you one more question?
Sure.
What is it? I mean, the make.
That's a 9mm Parabellum. It has 15 shots in the clip.
I want to know how to use it for protection.
That's not a good idea, Mrs. DeSilia. People who own guns don't get shot as often as people who do. I'd get rid of it if I were you.
Will you show me how it works?
Take the money back if I don't. Okay. You have a crossbolt safety above the trigger here. You push that off. You slide the top back and forth, and you're good to go, which is what I'm going to do. Okay? Thanks again. Be careful with that.
You're very direct. You admit some things, and then you stop.
No, I've got nothing to hide. I just felt like I was being called on the carpet with all the questions, you know what I mean?
I'm sorry. I am, really.
Okay. It's not your fault. I mean, I come in here with my story, and it's like, you know, why should you believe me?
But I do. Can you tell me something else?
Probably.
What's the difference between a porpoise and a dolphin?
And dolphins such as Davy, Mary, Betty, and Kipper, look, there's Kipper, have been performing here and delighting audiences like you for well over 25 years.
Are we ready? Let's go. Okay. Now, this double hand feeding can be a little tricky considering the wind today and the height. The dolphin could collide midair with a combined force of how many pounds? We wouldn't want that to happen because yours truly will be underneath. So here we go, ladies. Bonnie on my right,
Pebbles on my left. Come on, ladies. Here we go. Come on. Come on. Yes. And they got it. Let's hear it. Pebbles and Bonnie. What a great crowd. Let's hear it. Ladies and gentlemen, here's Brad.
Okay, folks, now the Skywalker is locked into position here on the north end of the ocean area. Tony's going to...
I love your routine, McGuire. You ever vary it?
Only when I forget my lines.
Like a hair?
Excuse me. Yeah. Beats tendon bar. Dolphin are a better class of customer.
I don't think that you're going to last.
No?
Uh-uh.
Maybe I'll head down to Key West, shoot tourists. Let's get something to drink.
You're not back to Detroit? We haven't talked about Detroit. Where did you go to school?
De La Salle by the airport.
I know where it is. I lived on the east side.
Where'd you go?
Dominican.
You're kidding me. You're no. Catholic?
Well, you know, not the kind I used to be.
Hmm. I sort of fell off myself. How old are you?
38. You?
35. Hmm. You don't look 38. Roger, wake
Thanks.
Up. Pepsi?
Fine.
Two.
Playing football on their
up.
Day off, huh? Yes!
Pretty great,
good
huh?
Good boy!
I used to work at a place called Marathon about 10 years ago. They had no tanks down there. Watch your step. They had these fences built out to the breakwater, kind of like pens. Watch your step there for the dolphins. And one night, I went out to the fences with some tin snips, and I cut them. It felt good. It felt good to watch them go.
Oh, I'd like that, just go.
I was on my way to France when the shit hit the fan.
I've never been.
You're kidding me.
No. I couldn't get Frank out of Florida.
Why do you sit in that house when you can do anything you want?
That is exactly what I've been thinking.
You want to have dinner with me tomorrow night? I'll take you anywhere you want to go. I just came into some money.
Okay, well, as I told you, the bonds are in the name of the administrator of the estate, Dorado Management. Yield, that's the interest. What did I say, six?
900,000.
Here we go.
Now that goes into the trust, so the bank deposits it or they credit it to your account.
900,000. Jesus, God damn, that's $15 million.
Yeah. Now that goes into the trust, so the bank deposits it or they credit it to your account. The $75,000 a month.
75.
That's it.
I said, all right. Man, that is it.
You served me with some kind of cease and desist order? From doing what? This is a very personal matter, Karen. You want to get something like this in the papers?
Yeah, if I have to, Ed. This is my goddamn life we're talking about.
Well, people wouldn't understand.
Well, of course they wouldn't. It's like something out of the Middle Ages, you know? I mean, do you know why he did it? He was having an affair, and I found out about it with a real estate woman. And I told him I wasn't even serious. I was mad. And I told him, if you're going to fool around, then I'm going to fool around, too.
Yeah, well, Frank took it at face value, and here we are.
All right, how about if I stood up at the jockey club and made a speech, just tap my glass with a spoon? May I have your attention, please? I want to tell you all something that you're not going to believe, but it's the God's honest truth, every word of it.
Karen, come on.
Oh, come on where? God damn it, Ed. What do you expect me to do? I'm a prisoner in my own living room.
Keep it down a little, all right? I understand how you feel.
Do you?
Even when I don't want to have anything to do with it, I have to satisfy my conscience that I've done something. I've gone through the motions. You understand? Then I say to myself, all right. All right. That's all I can do. You can't watch Karen the rest of your life. Frank wanted to teach her a lesson. There's the lesson. Did she learn it? I don't know. I say it's up to her. She knows his wish. Does she want to honor his wish? Or maybe it should be up to her now. Something between her and her husband.
Ed, just assign the bonds over to me and let's just stop all this.
I have to think about it a little more.
Keep Roland away from me.
Don't worry about Roland.
Where's Tardis?
Mrs. isn't here.
Where's she at?
She's not here.
Huh.
Let me see, please, if she's upstairs.
Just stay here, honey. Now, you call anybody on the telephone, I'll know about her. Come on now, hello, Reggie.
How you doing?
Marta!
Take off my hat for me.
Get off of me! Marta!
I told her we wouldn't be needing it.
Oh, it feels good, don't it? It's
been a long time, I bet. Huh?
Oh, sugar, where are we going? Where are you going, sugar?
Huh? I'm going to call Ed Grossi.
No, you don't want to bother Ed. This here between you and me, can you feel it? I caught my Louisville slugger.
I think I'd get better talk to Ed as soon as you can. Is it great? I'm not going to be watched anymore. This whole arrangement is over with.
Oh, no shit. Ed's called it off, huh? Huh?
Talk to him yourself.
What, did he check with Frank? What's Frank say about it?
Come on, baby, where's the soap? Let's get real clean again.
Go away! Please!
See, Mrs. DeChilia, it ain't up to Ed. But Frank said he's still hanging out there in the air somewheres. Frank didn't say, okay, never mind, just Ed said it. But Ed, his thinking's all fucked up, so that means I have to take over, see nobody gets close to you. You follow me, nothing's changed.
You start seeing somebody, the fella's likely to get a bone broken, not even know what for. And me, I'll be coming around. As long as I do, I'm still your big chance.
Karen. Hi, it's me, Mac. Listen, I'm running a little late. The girl who lives next door and lends me her car sometimes is not back yet.
Karen?
That's all right. Listen, why don't we make it some other time?
You know what? The car is no big deal. Why don't we just meet somewhere? Can we do that?
I guess we could.
You sound upset. Are you okay?
Where do you want to meet?
You know what? If you don't hear from me by 7:30, I'll meet you at the Yankee Clipper.
All right.
8 o'clock. You know where that is?
Uh-huh.
Good. I'll see you then.
I know why you come here. It's the window, like the dolphin tank.
Changing the subject again.
No, I just noticed it.
Karen, the other day when we talked, you were interested, you were relaxed. Tonight you're like a different person. What is going on with you?
All right, I have something on my mind. That happens, doesn't it? Minor problem comes along and you have to work it out.
Doesn't sound minor.
There's this guy at the bar in a white jacket, and I think I know him from somewhere. I just can't remember where.
I don't care about the guy at the bar, Karen.
Oh, God, I know that is. That's Marta's brother.
Karen, I've been arrested 9 times. And there's only one conviction on me.
Setting the dolphins free?
The dolphins. Last time I got in trouble, I promised. I even prayed, which I hadn't done in 20 years, that if I could get out of this, I'd never get in trouble again. But the other day, Frank DeCilia's widow asked me how to use a gun. Now, this lady can afford any kind of protection she wants, and yet she wants me to show her how to use a gun. That was the other day. Tonight, I want to know what the problem is. I want to help you.
You have blue eyes.
Mm-hmm. Yes, we both have blue eyes. We're both sort of Catholic. We're both from Detroit, and I want to know what you need, Karen.
There's a man.
I think he's gonna ask me for some money. A lot of money, and if I don't give it to him, I think that he's gonna kill me. You tell me what else I need.
Me. Check, please.
What are you doing back there?
You know what I thought about?
What?
The maid catching us.
Right.
Why? It's my house. I can do whatever I want.
That's the idea.
Well, I didn't think about it too much. I could hardly wait.
I could hardly wait to see you, too.
You know, I think you were miscast.
Oh.
You should have been somebody else.
Like what?
Well, I haven't decided yet, but you would have been in prison, you know that much.
Prison. Thank you. Prison. Talk about miscast, the lady of the house. I can't see you sitting around pouring tea all day long.
How do you see me?
Driving. France. Yeah.
Okay.
In France, yeah.
What kind of car do we have?
Convertible. Top down. We're not in it yet.
No?
No, we're in a cafe. Drinking wine.
Nice?
Sure.
Well, where we're headed after the wine?
South. Along the shore.
Spain.
Good. Good.
Rio.
Rio? That's a long drive, lady.
Yeah. Well, we have time, don't we?
Yeah, we do. We do.
Three martinis. You know what that does to me?
Four, and it makes you feel good.
No worries. No, you still have them. You just don't seem as real. Maybe that's the answer. Just stay in the bag and forget about it. And when he comes by, Marta can say, Mises has passed out.
That's one way. But this other idea about going to the cops, I don't see how it's going to do any good unless he's awful dumb.
Well, he acts dumb. But I don't know. He's so confident.
But he hasn't asked for anything yet, so it's not extortion. Anybody asks him, he works for your husband, right?
Well, he works for Ed Grossi now.
Now. But a guy like Roland's not going to be working for anybody much longer. Hey.
He ain't dead. He just looks it. Captivity will do that to you.
You stood on your head for me, Roland. Did 6 months in Butler. Don't think I forget that.
6 months ain't so bad.
What can I do for you?
It's a little thing.
I was supposed to see Ed, but he's out of town.
Did you try Vivian?
Vivian's out, too.
Is it important?
He'll chew my ass because I can't find him.
Oh, when they're both away, they're shacked up at Vivian's. Ed tells Clara he's gone to Pittsburgh or some other goddamn place. But they're up in Keystone.
Oh, hey, that reminds me. The company still managed that condo up in Boca.
Frank's chili had a place there he used by mistake.
That's right. He died there.
Well, I don't imagine anybody using it much no more. I know Lady ain't, because I'm the one watching her. But you know about that.
Jesus, that's a screwed up weird thing, isn't it? Ed told me something about it. I said, Jesus Christ, what are we, back in the fucking mountains of Sicily or Miami, Florida? We got better things to do than that. You're not a bad-looking broad either. You know that?
I'll tell you what, I got one firmer and younger up in Boca who's just dying for it. But this problem, see, she's a waitress at a place up there, and she's married. She can get out of the house only a couple hours in the evening, but I don't have no place to take her up there. Follow me? I mean, a nice place to impress her a little bit.
So you want Frank's a pup?
If it's just sitting there going to waste. I remember I took a piss there once. It had this great big bathtub. You walked up some steps to get in.
Yeah, clean up the waitress first. Sure, I'll get you a key anytime you want.
That'll be fine.
Gino, get the car.
Oh, hey, do you have Vivian's private number up here in Keystone?
Is it important?
Life or death situation, Jimmy. Ed likes me prompt.
Jeannie will get it for you.
Cute little fuckers. Endangered, I bet.
Who wants to see a triple somersault? Watch out here to the west wall. Whoa! Yes! Yay! That concludes our show. Please proceed to Shark Lagoon.
They already ate. What do you want?
This is a warning. Keep away from the woman. I'm talking about Mrs. DeCilio. Stay away from her. We're going to throw you in that tank for good.
You work for Roland? I guess you do. I gotta go.
No, don't work too hard.
First thing you do is fire your maid.
What about the brother?
He doesn't work for me. I don't believe it. Marta's been here as long as I have. I can't just fire
her. At least cancel her Christmas bonus. Excuse me. Take a look at this.
How? What does it do?
It's voice activated. You call somebody, you call somewhere, they know it. You want to send a message to Roland? Get rid of Marta.
Or keep her. Let them listen. Which is better, if Roland finds out we know about it, or if he doesn't? It could be to our advantage.
This is how they knew we got together last night.
But what did they learn, really? We could use some kind of code.
The question is, what did Roland find out before that made him go independent?
Like what?
Like, I don't know. Like, maybe you told somebody on the phone that you have money in the house. You spoke to your banker. It would be a way of indicating your worth.
Well, maybe somebody already knows I keep money in the house, like you, McGuire. What do you think I'm worth?
Well, $3 million, $30 million. Get into those figures, I don't think it makes much difference. But how does Roland get his hands on it if it's not here?
Roland hasn't asked me for anything.
He's leading up to it.
You haven't asked me for anything either.
What am I to help? You hiring me?
That's not an answer.
Say we do this. I'm gonna go back to my place. I'm gonna get changed. We're gonna go out to dinner. And I'm gonna tell you what I want. And you tell me what you want. How does that sound?
Well, I'll tell you what I want right now.
Okay.
I asked you, how's Barry?
He's in traction. He'll be in traction for 6 months. Also, his kidney and his spleen's messed up.
Boy's gonna die if you ought to do it in the deep end. You don't get outside enough. Look at you.
Look at me. How am I going to get outside? I'm on the phone all day. Now, you know what I got to do now? Borrow money. That's what I got to do. Get deeper in a hot. So I can buy time to try to put together some deals. Shit, outside.
You got this week's?
What are you talking about this week's? I don't know you till Friday.
Ed don't think you're going to pay it. Ed thinks you're going to skip. So he tells me, go see Arnie, get her done.
Wait a minute. Wait a minute. What's up?
Jesus Christ!
Now, wait a minute. Just wait. I'm going to pay you, man. Haven't I been paying you? I got some money now you can have.
Shut your eyes, Arnie. Close them tight. Just isn't your day, is it, Arnie? Come on, let's step outside. I ain't gonna throw you off. Stand out in the air while I tell you how you can get born again. All right? Come on.
I don't see why I can't meet him someplace here.
You got the DEA on your ass. Ed ain't gonna chance being seen with you around here. So you fly tomorrow, you go to the Ramada at the Detroit airport, and you wait for a call. Ed will get in touch with you there.
Then what?
Jesus Christ, didn't you tell me to get him to bank a couple more trips and he could have it all? Didn't you tell me that?
Yeah, right. I wasn't sure.
All right, this here's your flight. Noon. Take your JAG to the Fort Lauderdale Airport. Ramp 1 on the license plate, right? In case somebody wants to follow, make sure you get there on time.
Something's funny.
Okay, fine. Just forget the whole deal. I'll see you in 2 days for the VIG, and I'll see you next week, and I'll see you the week
It's not that funny. I mean, it's just a little funny. Not nearly as funny as that shit you pulled with a gun. You got a very weird sense of humor, man, if you don't mind my saying.
I don't mind. We were just having a little fun, weren't we, Arnie?
Hello?
Karen, how are you?
Who is this?
You know who it is.
Let me see. Is it Howard?
You know better than that.
Where are you?
I'm real close. In fact, I can't wait. Listen, let's meet tonight at the Yankee Clipper about 8 o'clock.
The Yankee Clipper?
Yeah, but there's somebody I've got to see first, so wait for me.
You won't make me wait too long, will you?
No, I won't.
Where does a cowboy get a hat like that?
Right in downtown Miami. Store there sells range clothes.
I believe that's the Oxbow model.
I bet I know where you're from. Out west?
How'd you know?
I can tell. Where do you think I'm from?
Well, I was gonna say the west. What? Vegas?
Shit, no, I'm from right here in Florida.
What are you, a cattle rancher? Ramen with the hump?
Nah, I was in cement, land development. Then I was a hunting fishing guide over in Big Cypress. Take these dinks out, don't know shit, one end of the airboat from the other.
Yeah, I was out in Tamiami one time.
A little restaurant over there all by itself. There's a lady there about 35, served me coffee one time. And then she sits at this table in the middle of the floor. I'm at the counter.
Yeah.
And she says, I love animals. And it just tears me up when one of them gets hit by a car.
Huh.
And I say to her, you here all by yourself? And she says, yes, I am. I say, you live here? She says, yes, I do. I say, you want to go in the bedroom with me in the back? And she says, I don't care.
Oh, shit, I know where that's at.
So we go back. And the entire time we're doing it, which is like 3 or 4 hours, you know, she doesn't say a word to me. So we come back outside. She sits down at the same table, right in the middle of the floor. And 20 minutes go by. Finally, she says, we found a parrot in the road. It was hit by a car the other day, brought it in the house, nursed it back to health, kept it in the bathroom to keep it warm. But it drowned in the commode.
Shit, I know a hunter just like her. I was down to Monroe Station, let's see, about 5 years ago for a catfish supper. Fucking place a mile and a half down the road. Man, I had to get out of there before I got covered with moss.
Ain't the Gold Coast, though. Land of opportunity.
You make $8,500 a year in a swamp, you're big stuff. Over here, you turn that up every week or so and sleep in on Saturday.
You know what you're doing.
You got some hair on your balls.
Yeah.
Right now, I'm lining up this deal. When it comes off, I'm gonna be set for life.
Was it land?
Land, you could say that. Land, house, a trust fund, pussy included.
Sounds pretty good.
Yeah.
You waiting on someone?
There's some people here I'm supposed to see, but if they don't come pretty quick, I'm going.
I'm going myself.
You know what'd be good? Pop one of them windows. See all that swimming pool water come pouring in here? People jumping up, trying to get out. Shit, the water pouring all over their dinner.
Get everybody's dinner wet. That would be good. Night.
Honey.
What are you calling here for? How'd you get this number?
Well, you gave it to me, darling, but don't worry, I won't tell your boyfriend.
I did not. It's Roland. I didn't give him this number.
I'll handle it. Yeah, Roland, what do you want?
Ed, hey, I hope I ain't taking you away from anything there, partner, but I got a little problem come up.
Are you sure, reporters? Yes? Yeah, I understand. God damn it, Roland. Just keep her away from her until I get there. Right away. Sit tight.
Until you get where?
Boca, the Chili's apartment.
You know, he said I gave him this number. I didn't. I know I didn't give it to him. What's he doing there?
He says Karen was drunk and talking to some reporter in a restaurant. Roland followed her. It looked like she was going to meet someone. Turns out it's a reporter. So he took her to the apartment.
What restaurant?
He didn't say.
Oh, Ed, come on, babe. You're getting old. Call her at home.
What do you mean? Call her at home. She's at the apartment. I heard her voice, and then Roland said she was sitting. She went in the bathroom.
Why'd he drive her to Boca? Why not home?
He says the reporter would probably go there. She says that Karen is going to tell her everything unless I speak to her first. Jesus Christ. The bullshit things that we get into.
Let's call him back.
An unlisted number. I don't know what it is.
I'll go to the office and get it. 40 minutes.
Vivian, I heard her voice on the telephone. She is at the apartment, okay? You can drive me.
Ed, I had never given him this number. I know goddamn well I never gave it to him.
Come on, let's go.
I never want to see that animal again, understand?
Not mad.
I know when you're mad, whether you admit it or not.
Well, if you know when I'm mad, even when I'm not, then you should know what I'm not mad at. Let's just forget it.
Ed, I want to go with you.
I said wait.
She may need a woman to be with her.
You know why I'm mad? I'm mad because you said I was old. That's why.
Ay, mi vida. You're not old. You're mine.
Hey, Ed, I was sleeping.
Where is she?
She's in the bathroom. Sounds like she's a little sick.
Karen?
She might have passed out again. Better look up in there and see.
Karen? Where is she?
Oh, my God.
Rosie's body was found in the trunk of a suspected drug dealer's car at Fort Lauderdale International Airport. The suspected drug dealer, Arnold Rapp, had fled but was soon apprehended in Detroit by fast-moving FBI agents and headed over to the Dade County Police. After searching, the body was discovered in Rapp's condo parking lot. Rapp has been charged with first-degree murder. No bond has been set at this time. Two teenagers...
Water. Mrs. isn't home now.
Where is she?
I don't know. She got in a car and drove.
You know I'm a friend. You know I want to help, right? Right? I need to speak to your brother.
Jesus?
Yeah, he can help me with Roland.
I could talk to him.
Can you get him to meet me somewhere?
I think he may leave town.
Okay,
he's going.
Call him. No, wait a minute. You can't call him. I know you can't call anybody from here, right?
I could go somewhere to call him. The drugstore.
That's absolutely perfect. Please do it. It's important. Please.
Only the man's coming.
Don't
to
worry
fix the
about
bed.
It. I know where the bed is. Okay, I'll stay here. Please. Thank you, Martha. Thank you.
As soon as I saw it on the news.
Where the hell were you?
I know.
I am
sorry. No,
I went to your hotel. I was driving.
Honey,
and then there was nowhere else I could go.
Ann's
dead.
Come here.
He's dead and he can't change a thing.
Karen, that's not true.
It's not the Roland now.
It's not the Roland now.
What am I supposed to do? It's not the Roland.
Wait, where
are you?
Karen!
Where are you?
Come here. Karen, hold it! No, hold it. Come on, honey, come here, honey, look at me, honey, there's a way out of this,
How?
I have to find out, look at me, I need you on this. I have to find out if Roland's in charge. If he is in charge, I will go and see him. Now, who knew Ed's business?
Vivian!
I don't know Vivian. Who's Vivian?
She's Ed's secretary, but I've been trying to reach her all day on the car phone, and I get a voice that says she's not there, and nobody will give me her home number.
Okay. I will go, Karen. I will go and see Vivian. I will handle this. Okay? I will handle this.
You will want to?
Yes. Will you hang in there till I get back?
Yeah.
Good. You hang in there till I get back. Okay, I'll be back soon.
Karen!
Been talking to Roland lately?
I don't work for Roland no more.
Did you know Ed Grassi's dead? Means anything can happen now, Jesus. I need to know what Roland means to Mrs. DeCilia, Jesus.
She's got friends of her husband there. Mr. Grossi wasn't the only one.
She doesn't know them. Jesus, I need to know where Vivian Arzola is. You take me to her?
She's got a place in town. Another place I hear about in Keystone. But I don't know where.
She got family in Miami?
I took something once to her mother. She lives in Homestead. Vinny gives her, you know, the support.
You take me to her?
Maybe I can do that.
How about Roland? Does he live alone?
Man, you think anybody would live with him?
You take me to him?
I don't think so.
No? How about with a gun? With a gun?
You ever do things like that?
If I have to.
Mrs. DeCilia, she want this?
She doesn't know it yet, but she does.
No, she don't want to think about it.
$5,000, Jesus! $5,000! That's a lot of money. Take me to him, and you get the five.
I'll think about it. Ponle 50, vamos ya!
You know, standing out there, I got to thinking about another Cuban lady I like to visit. And I used to say to her, honey, I just see your street sign, I get a boner. That's a compliment, Marty. How you doing?
Mrs. is very busy.
Well, we won't bother her. Why don't we just go to your room and stay at home?
Oh, but you feel good. You got a brassiere on under there? No, oh, I like that. Let's see if we got any panties on.
Yes, I am. I'm gonna get you. I'm gonna get you.
Come on, you little menudo. Get over here and give me a kiss. You're hurting my feelings now. Come on, Marty. So, come on, baby. That's it. Can I call you Karen? You know, man knows a woman like I know you. Married name just seems too formal. You're different. You're calmer. I don't mean you're ever excitable, but there's something different about you. Is there something bothering you you're holding in?
You talk a lot, but you never get to the point.
I believe I owe you a few bucks. I broke some plates inside there.
Just tell me what you want.
I'm not bragging or anything, but ladies have asked me that before. What do you want? They say anything.
I haven't said anything.
Not yet. Just because you got $15 million don't make you any different from them. Other ladies asked me what I wanted. And I was in no position to be near as nice to them as I am to you. See, poor old Ed Grossi passed on before he changed anything. And guess who they put in charge?
That would be the police.
Well, shit, girl, put on some lemonade. Hey, come on, sit down. You son of a gun. You knew it was me the other night in the bar, didn't you?
You okay?
Yeah.
Did you tell her the story about the woman with the parrot?
I don't believe he has.
This woman had a sick parrot she kept in the bathroom. Christ, spent weeks nursing him back to health, got it well again, and the parrot, you know what it did? Tried to get a drink of water in the toilet and drowned.
That's the story.
That's the story, but that's not how you tell it. Not how you tell it. You don't say that the parrot is trying to get a drink of water.
Then what's the parrot doing in the toilet?
I believe he's trying to get a drink of water, but that's not the point.
Well, that's the goddamn parrot wanting it. Then say it. Otherwise, it don't make sense what the goddamn parrot's doing.
How about I tell it my way, you tell it your way? And you got the hat. Always wear that?
Oh, you want to take it off me?
No. No, sir. I think it looks good. Tells who you are.
And who do you say I am?
Well, with the range hat and those boots and the suit, I'd say you're with the circus.
That's a good guess. You know what I do in the circus?
You're one of the clowns.
Catch your breath,
Sandy.
We just wrestling.
Out of the pool, please.
Oh, jeepers, officer. It's awful cool in here. Such a hot night and all.
Get out of the pool.
Sorry, partner. It's been trying for wrestling later, huh?
Can I see some sort of identification, please?
No, sir. You got no call to see my identification.
Turn him around.
Hey, come on, man. Since you didn't see nothing before you start acting all badass, who's your complaining witness? It's all right, Marty. Tell him. Heck, we just playing around now, weren't we?
Do you want to make a complaint, Mrs. DeCilia?
You know who I am. Of course you know who I am.
There you go. Everybody knows Mrs. DeCilia. She's married to Frank DeCilia. Now, the fact is, officers, we have our disagreements. We get into arguments just like anybody else. But if we was to start explaining everything to you, you'd be writing reports all night and on your day off. Now, wouldn't you?
No. No complaint.
Say goodnight, partner. Let's go. Thanks.
Night, Mart. Jesus Christ on a cross, Lionel. How do you live in this dump? Goddamn place ain't bigger than a horse trailer. The whole neighborhood stinks.
He doesn't stink, man.
Get him out of here.
Hey, he's my father. He don't
I don't give a shit if he's Juan Batista. Tell him the vominos.
Papi, don't call out the boquete.
Come on, baby. Let's go. Andale.
Vera.
Out of here. Christ. Lionel, look at this goddamn place. You work for me, you're going to have to clean yourself up.
I work for you now?
I want you to find Vivian Arzola. Her and you both used to pick oranges, right? Go look up some of your old buddies.
No, that was a long time ago, man.
Jesus.
How come I work for you now, huh? Well, why you don't get Jesus?
Jesus left town.
No, Jesus didn't go nowhere, man. I saw him talking to this guy yesterday at Centro Vasco.
You see him again? You tell him to give me a call. Tell him I don't hear from him, and I see him on the street, I'm going to bust his little bow legs and wrap him around his dink head. You find Vivian. You follow me? Find Vivian.
Vera, ven y limpia tus platos, anda.
I won't tell anyone.
Calm down.
Oh, God. Just looking for you, that's all.
Please.
Relax. Calmate, senora. I'm just looking for you. That's all.
Guar.
You want to hear something funny? Remember when I told you about I cut the fences, let the dolphins go free? They came right back. When they got hungry, they came right back. They didn't want to be free. They were just playing games.
I'm sorry about last night.
I could tell by the way you're sitting there watching me.
No, would it help if I kicked him in the shins?
It's windy as smoke.
Well, Roland made his point, didn't he? They can hit close to home. There's nothing I can do about it. He pretends he's going to rape Marta. I call the police, and Marta won't talk. Police won't do a goddamn thing about it.
Seem pretty cool about it. Got that ape hanging on you.
Oh, guess what he wants? He finally said it. He wants me. I mean, everything, including me. He says I'm going to reach a point where I want to give him everything. Like, he's going to be my only chance.
And you believe it?
Oh, he's got more confidence than anybody I've ever met.
It's not confidence, Karen. That's bullshit.
Yeah, but don't you see that his confidence is his flaw? I mean, what's he got to base it on? Watching you two in the pool, you know what it was like? Two little boys showing off in front of a girl.
You don't get it. Roland is going to rip you off, and if you end up with a broken head, that's going to be tough shit.
Well, it made me think of something that Ed Grossi said. A guy's a lightweight. Sooner or later, it shows.
Ed Grossi told you that?
Yep.
You want some more free advice? Fuck Ed Grossi. Fuck Ed Grossi. I'm going to see Vivian Arzola.
Vivian?
Hey, Sue's found her. She's been hiding out in her cousin's house in Coconut Grove.
Why didn't you just go to the police?
Because Roland will kill me, why do you think?
Fuck Roland. Even look at my sister again.
But he'd be in jail.
Bullshit. He'll be out on bond. He won't be in jail.
But the police would protect you.
Excuse me, but I have worked for Mr. Grossi for 12 years, and if they want a person dead, that person is dead, because this is what Roland does. It's his job. You understand?
To kill people?
Oh, man, ¿por qué me la traiste? You don't know. Yeah, Roland can go to jail, and he can pay somebody else to do it, or he can wait. Don't you know that? Best case, they convict him, and I look at the clock for 10 years. Then what?
I don't know. McGuire?
Yep.
What are you going to do?
What do you think I'm gonna do?
I think I'd run.
I won't run.
No, I know you would. Roland's out there. He killed Ed. He can kill anybody he wants.
Hey, Sue's will look after Vivian.
For how long?
She won't go to the police.
The day Roland dies, she will. And we're home free.
Look, I'm sorry, man. Hey, you know I got your job, Jesus. It's
keep,
a lot of work.
Keep it.
Hey, tell me one thing, Jesus. What could Roland want with Vivian Arzola, man?
He's looking for her.
He came to my trailer yesterday. He insulted me. Then he hired me to find her, you know?
You have any luck?
Yeah, that's what he was, too, man. Do you know her cousin? She has some houses to rent. Well, I'm talking to this guy, just to know her, you know? And he said, yeah, one of these houses on Monegro has been vacant for a month, man. But then he thinking he saw a light going in there, and he think he saw her going there the other day. So I go down to the house, you know, I look in the window, bam, that's Vivian right there, man. I'm knocking on the door, and I'm knocking, pero she no answer,
yeah. She probably don't want to see anybody.
Hey, fuck that, man. You know, I'm not going to bother her.
You tell Roland where she is?
Yeah, I just called him, but you know, that's why I'm asking you, man, because, you know...
I need your car.
But wait.
I need to borrow your car.
Okay, but I'm gonna meet him back later. Jesus! I'm gonna meet him back later! Oh, yeah! Jesus!
shit. You ain't Vivian.
She was my cousin, you know. She owned houses in the Grove for years. I used to go there when things got bad. Epifania, that was her name. I know she didn't know that I was there. I know she didn't. Maybe she went there to check up.
We do it tonight. Tonight, at the DeCilia house. The cops have already been there when Roland tried to grab Marta, so he'll come armed. Only this time we'll be there to defend her, and we'll kill him.
I kill him. Okay, it's my sister.
You sure?
Certo. How do we get Roland to come?
Roland is going to come because he thinks Vivian is going to be at the house.
No, well, Vivian is in Cuba. That's where Vivian is.
You don't have to be there. He has to think that you're there. And we can make him believe that with Karen's phone. I'm going to call you on Karen's phone, and I'm going to say, Vivian, it's all set up. You're going to spend the night here, and first thing in the morning, we're going to take you to the cops, and you're going to say, okay, we got to make sure that Marta gives Lionel that tape so that when Roland hears your voice on the tape, he's going to know it's you, and he's going to come.
What if he doesn't listen to the tape?
We back it up. Jesus, you're going to tell Lionel that she's going to be at the house around 11:30. Very mysterious. So this way, if Roland doesn't listen to the tape, at least he's heard it from Lionel.
I can't use my gun. Not for this.
There's a gun in Frank DeCilia's office upstairs. So this way, if the cops want to bust somebody for possession, they dig up old Frank. The key to that file cabinet is in Karen's top dresser drawer.
You're crazy. You know that. Yeah. And you better do it good, because this is Roland Crowe we're talking about here. I know Roland.
So, it's simple. Roland comes to kill Vivian.
But I shoot him like he's coming after Marta. Self-defense.
We do it tonight, and we're home free.
Vivian. Hey, listen, it's McGuire. Right, it's all set. I'm gonna pick you up at 11:30 and bring you right back here. Right.
What the hell are you doing?
I'm just making a call. Don't worry
about
it. What?
Are you looking for a rematch? I mean, Roland's gonna hear you, and then what am I supposed to
do?
What am I supposed
Karen,
to do?
Listen to me. I want you to drive to Miami tonight. I want you to check into the Marriott, go shopping, go to the movies, do whatever you want to do. Just wait for my call.
I saw it on TV, you know, the pink house, the woman.
It
wasn't Vivian. I know it wasn't, but it was someone, and she's dead, and it was Roland. It has to be. He's out of control. And you're telling me to take a shopping trip?
Honey, listen to me. You want me to help you with Roland? You got to do what I'm telling you to do. Please drive to Miami and stay there until I call. Would you do that for me? Karen, do that for me. Yes, Miami. And you have to be out of here by 8 o'clock. 8 o'clock. Please, honey, please. Would you do that for me? 8 o'clock and wait for my call. Good?
Yeah.
Good.
What are we going to do?
We're going to be fine. Come here. You just hang on. You're going to hang on? Hang on.
If you are ready for dinner.
No, thank you, Marta. I'm having dinner out. What's the matter? Marta? Marta, what's the matter?
I don't want to be here alone.
Well, you can just take the night off. That's fine. Just...
I can't.
Yeah, leave all that. That's fine.
I can't.
Why not? Why not?
Jesus told me to stay here tonight.
He did?
No matter what.
Why? What did he tell you? What did he tell you, Marta?
I must be here tonight.
Why?
Jesus said so. He's so sensible. Tell you what. You take a couple of days off. Take a week.
But me.
Fact. Leave right now. There's no sense in putting yourself in something that doesn't concern you. Understand, Marta?
Yes, miss.
Go now. Leave.
Yes,
Marta. Would you put my bag in the car, please?
Yes, miss. Miss, I wish things could be the same, the way they used to be.
Yeah, wouldn't that be nice?
Set. I'm going to pick you up and bring you straight back here. And the first thing in the morning, we're going to go to the police.
Oh, man, I'm so afraid he's going to find me. I can't sleep. I can't eat. Oh, God, I can't even think.
Vivian, you got to sit tight. It's going to be over soon. Vivian, tonight at 11:30. Tonight at 11:30. Tonight at 11:30.
That's what his sister told me.
No, man, no. Jesus didn't say nothing about his sister. He said Vivian.
Vivian? And what did Vivian say?
It's like I told you, man. She said some guy was going to come pick her up around 11:30.
Well, that's interesting, Lionel. That's very interesting.
Well, you know, that's my job, man. It's part-time, but, you know.
I got this tape here. Says Vivian's going to be at Karen's house at 11:30 tonight and delivered by Marta, whose panties I tore off. And I got her brother, Jesus, little fucking pissant who hates my guts, tipping you to the identical time and place all in the same afternoon. Shit, Lionel, only thing missing is an engraved invite and a basket of fruit.
I don't understand, man. I don't understand.
I believe you are as ignorant as you look. Lucky for you, partner.
Pretty lady.
Pretty boy.
You want something to drink or something? It would be my pleasure.
Do you know who I am?
No, not completely.
My name is Karen DeChia. Maybe you read it in the papers.
You're famous, huh?
Say it.
What?
Say my name.
Karen.
DeChia.
Karen DeChia.
Good. Now tell me yours.
Luis.
Luis? I'm going to remember that.
Me too. Listen, I'm going to go back to the bar and get us a refill on the drinks, okay? You stay cool. I'll be back.
Sí, 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 no me voy, yo me voy. Tú, que si me voy.
You're late.
We got a problem.
Is Marta ready?
Not exactly, no. See, that's the problem.
What are you talking about?
Marta split. He can't find her.
I don't know where she is. Besides, she's not where she's supposed to be. No, Marta, no self-defense, right?
Roland doesn't know that.
What are you doing?
He's going to be there at 11:30.
What are you doing?
I'm finishing what I started.
You had a plan when you started. It's almost 10.
Okay, you both stay here. Give me your gun, Jesus.
I don't got it. Remember, you told me we're going to use the gun in the house. Call it off, man. You don't want to do this alone.
Maybe it's better this way.
Better for who, McGuire? Hey, McGuire! She ain't that pretty and she ain't that rich.
Take a piss and you drown in the toilet.
It's commode, Hopalong.
Yeah, I think it sounds better, toilet. Where's Vivian at?
Vivian.
We're gonna have a question and answer period here, or we gonna get to it?
I got nothing to tell you.
Well, then you might as well be dead, huh?
Going for two counts?
Two? If I was to notch my gun butt, you'd get splinters running your hand on it, asshole. I don't care about numbers. You're just another one.
It's all about the money, though, isn't it?
What do you make? $2 an hour? You want to slip me $100?
I ain't got it, but I know where to get it.
We're going to be partners, huh?
Yeah, why not?
Well, that's good, but I just got one question for you. Where's Vivian?
I can't do it like you. I can't have it on my conscience.
Well, how can you do it?
You know what? I can't.
Well, shit, then. Let's hunt.
Mr. Key.
Fuck!
Are you coming down or am I coming up? Well, hot damn, the gang's all here. I hope we can get this cleared up. What's going on?
You have a light?
You know, I used to chew, but I never smoked. It's bad for you. You got a match?
Don't smoke.
That's smart. See, the way I see it, it's this asshole here causing all the commotion. He tells you bedtime stories about Ed Grossi and Vivian. You get all riled up, figure it's your civic duty to pitch in and help the poor little lamb. Now, first off, don't believe everything you hear. Second, it looks like there's been a change of plan. Like, he figured to get a lot of money from you, pretend it was to help Vivian get away. Only he shows up here, you're not here, so he waits.
He was waiting, all right, but he was waiting for you.
That's the idea.
Wait for me. Why would he do that?
To kill you. McGuire used Vivian as bait, but what he really wanted was an excuse to shoot you in self-defense. As if you came back here to rape Marta.
Damn, that's some plan.
Thanks.
It's a half a plan. Truth is, I make a much better victim. Think about it. Mafia widow gets lonely, goes out on the town, meets a boy who will remember her later. The widow returns home, discovers a midnight intruder, and he gets killed in self-defense. Now that is front page material.
You guys are kooky. Shit, he don't even have a gun.
I do. How did you get in?
Sliding glass door, living room.
No, that's how Roland got in. You weren't here.
I'll tell what happened. I don't care about being involved.
You were never here. You better leave, okay? I have to inform the police.
But it was my idea.
Well, it wasn't a very good one. First, I noticed that Roland was pointing a shotgun at your head. Why didn't you take it?
Why didn't I take what?
The money. You locked the dog in Frank's office.
Well, I met you. I figured my luck was changing.
What did you expect to get out of it?
Convertible, top down, bottle of wine.
Did I promise you anything? For your time.
You're just like the dolphins, you know that? Cut you loose, and you come back to play games.
Everybody plays games, McGuire. Beat it. I have to make some calls. Over you go.
Real.